Earlier session, we have already discussed the purposes of annealing heat treatment. Now, in this session, we will extend the same discussion by studying types of annealing processes. I am Mr. P.P. Mitragotri, Associate Professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. The outcome of learning for today's session will be that is, students will be able to apply proper type of annealing process for desired changes in properties to be brought about. All we will discuss what are the various types of annealing. First annealing process is full annealing. Full annealing, the name itself suggests that it will solve most of our purposes, that is, it will refine the grain structure, it will restore the ductility in cold worked components, it will fully relieve the stresses after manufacturing, it will restore electrical and magnetic properties, it will soften the steel, as well it will prepare the structure for hardening, except improving machinability of hyper-eutectoid steel and tool steel, and except homogenization, all other purposes can be solved by full annealing. That is why this treatment is called as full annealing treatment. And full annealing treatment is always carried out by heating the steel 25 to 30 degrees above A3 temperature. That is, if we plot a graph of temperature versus time, we can show the treatment, full annealing treatment, like this. Heating, holding, and cooling in furnace very slowly. Slow heating and holding, sufficient holding, is very essential to get most desired structure and thereby desired properties. Now, next annealing is annealing to restore the ductility of cold worked products, that is recrystallization annealing. In this case, crystal structure is restored, stresses are relieved in cold worked components, and further processing can be done. And this annealing is a subcritical annealing, and it can be shown in the same diagram like this. This is recrystallization annealing. This is full annealing. So we have studied two types of annealing in this. Now third type of annealing will be stress relief annealing. Stress relief annealing is basically intended to relieve the stresses developed after manufacturing. This process is basically intended for casting, for forging, as well as for welded structures. This annealing is very useful. And in this stress relief annealing, which is also a subcritical annealing, which is carried out at around 600 to 650 by heating the steel at a temperature of 600 to 650 degrees Celsius, slowly heating it, holding it at that temperature, and cooling it slowly to room temperature. Now, before moving to the next type of annealing, I would like to pose a question to you, that is, what is the difference between recrystallization annealing and stress relief annealing? Now, next annealing is recovery annealing. Recovery annealing is carried out at a temperature of 300 by heating the steel to a temperature of 300 to 350, at the most 400 degrees Celsius, and cooling it, holding it at that temperature for sufficient length of time, and cooling it slowly to room temperature. recovery annealing will recover electrical and magnetic properties of the steel, but will not be able to relieve the stresses completely, but 50 to 60% of the stresses are relieved. Now, recovery annealing is the best substitute for stress relief annealing in some cases, because many of the welded structures or many of the castings are full of stresses. And if we allow the stresses to remain as it is, those will cause problems in functioning. But if we relieve the stresses totally, steel will get softened and we require to retain the hardness. Under such circumstances, we may carry out recovery annealing by which we can reduce the stress level to a minimum without affecting mechanical properties. And that is the most important aspect of recovery annealing. Now, next annealing process is important in improving machinability of hyper-eutectoid steel and tool steel, that is ferroizing annealing in hyper-eutectoid steels and in alloy tool steels, which are used to manufacture dies and tools used in various processes like forging, extrusion. We find that machinability of hyper-eutectoid steel and tool steel is very poor. We are unable to machine these to the required tolerances. For that reason, we require to make it machinable. And for that, we have to spheroidize the perlite present in hyper-eutectoid steel and tool steel, and we have to break the cementite network and carbide network present around perlite grain boundaries. And that is achieved by spheroidizing annealing. And this spheroidizing annealing is carried out by heating the steel 30 degrees above A1 temperature and holding it there for sufficient length of time and cooling slowly to room temperature. We can show this treatment on temperature versus time graph like this. Now, next annealing is homogenization annealing. Homogenization annealing is carried out to remove the chemical inhomogeneity developed in the structure during manufacture. And to remove the chemical inhomogeneity developed in the structure during manufacture, this homogenization annealing is carried out by heating the steel 100 to 150 degrees above A3 temperature, holding it there for sufficiently long period of time, and then cooling it very slowly to room temperature. This is very essential for homogenization. This homogenization annealing is also known as diffusion annealing. Here, diffusion of alloying elements from one location to another location is most important. For diffusion, we require to have very high temperature, as also we require to give sufficient time. And by holding at very high temperature, at around 1050 or 1100 degrees Celsius, we can carry out homogenization of the structure. But in homogenization, after homogenization is achieved, we invite another trouble. That is, our structure is homogenized, but due to prolonged holding at very high temperature, we have very coarse-grained structure developed in the steel. And this coarse-grained structure will hamper many of the properties of the steel. So after homogenization annealing, it is always mandatory to carry out full annealing so that we can have refinement in grain size and structure. So you might have learned that homogenization annealing alone can never be a heat treatment suggested for alloy steel castings. After homogenization annealing, there will always be a full annealing treatment. And along with this, there is one more treatment called as isothermal annealing. This isothermal annealing is carried out by heating the steel above A3 temperature, cooling it below A1 temperature slowly, and holding it at that temperature for sufficient length of time for a long period, and then cooling it slowly. But this isothermal annealing is not practically exercised in many of the industries. Many of the industries will exercise all the treatments that we have discussed. Now, out of these six treatments, we find that our stress relief annealing, reconstruction annealing, and recovery annealing are the treatments which are carried out below A1 temperature. So these treatments can also be regarded as a subcritical annealing. So today we have discussed most metallurgy by Avnar. So hope you have understood the thing. Have a nice day. Thank you.